Leukemia is a type of cancer, starts in the blood forming cells in the bone marrow with excess of white cell production. Normal white cells are supposed to help immune system, whereas the abnormal production of the white cells, they're not functionally good, hence they lead on to symptoms like excess infection, another symptom complex related to leukemia. So it is almost like an overproduction of white cells, which shouldn't be happening, with very immature types of cells circulating in the blood. Normal blood cells are produced inside the bone marrow. They come from a common stem cells, which produces various different blood cells, including red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. The red blood cells are produced mainly to carry the oxygen levels in the blood, and it is the main symptom which causes towards tiredness. The white blood cells are mainly to fight infections, and they're mainly of two different types: granulocytes, which constitutes predominant part of the white cells, and they are the main fighting power towards infection. If you don't have enough white cells, there are high risk of infection. Similarly, the lymphocytes are a different way of fighting infections. They have two different types: T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes. The B lymphocytes produces antibody and they fight infections. And the T lymphocytes are like a memory cells. Right from the birth, the baby's having vaccinations, they're all stored in those memory cells all the lifetime. So it is a very important type of cells. And platelets are the third type of cells, which produce mainly to help stopping bleeding. And they're produced from cells called megakaryocytes. And it is very important that to have these cells to prevent bleeding. Symptoms of leukemia can be quite vague, which depends on the types of blood cells affected. The most common feature is related to red blood cells, which is anemia, which can cause severe fatigue, malaise, and tiredness. The white cells' involvement can lead on to increased risk of infections, predominantly chest infections, water infections, skin infections, which can be the main presentation. Whereas involving the platelets, which mainly bleeding manifestations, including nosebleeds, gum bleeds, and excessive periods in females, which can be the main presentation. And also it can cause bone pain, which is more common with the acute lymphoblastic leukemia, and also increased spleen and liver size, which can again cause abdominal pain, which can be a feature, and excessive bruising can be another feature of acute leukemia. The leukemia can be divided into acute leukemias and chronic leukemias. The acute leukemias again is classified into acute myeloid leukemia and acute lymphoblastic leukemia. The acute myeloid leukemia is a common presentation in adult leukemia, whereas acute lymphoblastic leukemia is more common in children. And chronic leukemias can again be subclassified into chronic myeloid leukemia, which is less common, and chronic lymphatic leukemia, which is much more commoner in the Caucasian population. Treatment of leukemias have evolved over the last few decades. The acute leukemias, mainly the acute myeloid leukemia and acute lymphoblastic leukemia, is predominantly still treated with chemotherapy, mainly inpatient-based chemotherapy, which is combined with immunotherapy as well, part of clinical trials. And there is also a major contribution by the stem cell transplantation, which has made the treatment very effective in this group. Coming to chronic leukemias, it is mainly a field of targeted treatment. In chronic myeloid leukemia, the tyrosine kinase inhibition has been a very successful story and has almost replaced the previous option of stem cell transplantation. And in chronic lymphatic leukemia, there may be a proportion of patients may not need any treatment and do watch and wait. But when they need treatment, there's various treatment options targeting various molecules and cell membrane receptors like Bruton tyrosine kinase, PI3 kinase, and BCL2 inhibition, and which has made the CLL treatment extremely effective and has got good leukemia kill. The general outlook for acute leukemias is improving, especially acute myeloid leukemia and acute lymphoblastic leukemia with the chemotherapy, immunotherapy, and stem cell transplantation has made a massive progress and people are getting cured. But the elderly population, it is still a challenge with various new modalities of treatment is very promising. The chronic myeloid leukemia, the story is much more fruitful and it is almost made a huge impact by the targeted treatments. They're almost having a good quality of life and longer survival with the new modalities of treatment, especially chronic myeloid leukemia and chronic lymphatic leukemia. And this has made an increased lifespan as well as good quality of life.